It was a mild day in Miami with a little rain, but out west, winter has arrived. Don Carson says it's white all over.
Oh, that's for sure, Bob. You know, yesterday we were talking about the heavy snowfalls in Arizona of 6 inches, but today, over parts of Colorado, up to 20 inches of snow. It's still snowing right now, and they expect more snow tonight. Talk more about that in just one moment. First, let's check out our current information. And talking about all that snow, it's kind of nice to look at that temperature reading here in Miami of 78 degrees right now. Barometer is 30.07 inches and steady. Humidity is 64%. Winds out of the east, northeast at 8. Surf reading is 76 degrees. Sunrise will be at 6:27. Sunset at 5:42. And on radar, after quite a few showers this afternoon, we still have some rain around at this hour. And most of that is widely scattered along the coastal areas of Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach counties. And we also have some showers along the west coast. This rain is moving right now southwestward at about 17 miles an hour. Let's go now to our satellite still photo. And just about the entire southeastern part of the country, including Florida, was able to stay under mostly clear skies this third day of November. But as we can see here and on the film loop, lots of cloud activity was a story just about everywhere else. Now, the clear skies over the southeast are due to a rather large area of high pressure centered this afternoon over the state of South Carolina. And in addition to keeping things kind of sunny, it also brought us our northeasterly and easterly flow of air today. Partly cloudy skies over the northeast and New England today, where right now it's 50 degrees in Boston, New York, reporting 55. It's 44 degrees in Chicago. We have a cold front here that extends all the way from the Great Lakes area, goes through two low pressure cells and down into Mexico. Some scattered showers, thunder showers, some very heavy thunderstorms have been seen along the line of this system today. The heaviest rain between Missouri and Texas, where some flooding is reported. And we talked about all that heavy snow, not just over Colorado, but also some parts of Kansas. Again, some isolated areas reporting between 18 and 20 inches of snow this afternoon, and they have heavy snow warnings out for the same area for tonight. Some very cold air was drawn down into the Northern Rockies and the Northern Plains region. This morning it got down to 17 degrees at Grand Forks, North Dakota. A bit further west, rain and some rain mixed with snow around the area of this low pressure cell in Utah. For the far west, partly cloudy skies today. Now, as this cold front continues to go eastward tonight and tomorrow, some rain, some of it quite heavy, is expected all the way over as far east as some parts of New York, Pennsylvania, through Tennessee and Alabama. However, we will continue to be under the influence of this high pressure cell, which will keep just about the entire state of Florida under partly sunny skies. We will continue to see scattered showers, though, mainly over the southern half of the state. Night and morning fog again for the northern part of the state, including the panhandle. And the lows tonight will be in the 50s over the northern part of Florida, 60s just about everywhere else, except for the low 70s along the lower east coast and the Keys. Highs tomorrow over the state of Florida will be in the 80s just about everywhere. Right now it's 76 degrees at both Palm Beach and Lauderdale, 77 at Fort Myers and Key West. Let's take a look now at that local forecast for Miami and vicinity. We call it partly sunny. Again, look for some more scattered showers through Tuesday. Low tonight about 68. High tomorrow in the low 80s. Winds out of the northeast at 15. Seas 4 to 6 feet. Bays and in the waters will have a moderate chop. And that's our weather for now. Bob will be back with more news for you right after this.
Palaka.
We've still got some leftover problems, I guess you'd call them, from Tropical Storm Dennis, and now another problem.
Hurricane Floyd.
If it continues its present course, how soon will it get here?
Well, I think Monday night or Tuesday, if it continues its present course. And the steering currents are very light, so it might not even get here. We'll take a look at exactly where it's at in just a moment. First, let's look at those current conditions out at Miami International. 83, 79 up at Fort Lauderdale, and 82 at West Palm Beach. Barometer is 29, 97 and rising. Humidity, 79%. Winds out of the east at 10, and no report on that surf temperature. On the radar, let's first look at that. We have a few showers continuing out in the western parts of Dade and Broward, actually even over closer into the Glades. Some more showers and thunderstorms continue offshore. These should continue into the nighttime hours, probably into the early morning hours, and then they should diminish, and probably tomorrow afternoon we'll have another round, about a 50% chance of rain in our area. Now let's take a look at Hurricane Floyd. As you see on our satellite, we have him located out near Puerto Rico, actually north of Puerto Rico, moving to the northwest at about 10 miles per hour. Now those current coordinates are 23.0 north, 68.0 west, and with that track and those coordinates, it's bringing it right up the chute toward our region. Now as I said, the steering currents are very light, so we're not really sure where it's going to go, but there are hurricane warnings out for Turk and Caicos Islands, and a hurricane watch out for part of the southern Bahamas. Floyd moving toward the northwest. That current national map looks like this. We have a cold front out in the west that's bringing cooler air down into the northwestern United States, flooding along the front down in and around Utah. But we have a lot of sunshine, well, at least sunny until the sun went down, from the southwestern United States all the way up to near the Great Lakes. But another low pressure area is bringing rain to the Great Lakes, warm, stormy conditions throughout the southeastern United States. Now let's look at the forecast for some of our favorite cities after we take a look at the forecast for Florida. 90 degree temperatures throughout the interior of the state, 80 degree temperatures all the way around the exterior of the state, and that should bring some afternoon thunderstorms to our area, especially in the western part of the state and up in the north, partly cloudy skies right down along the coastal area itself. Now let's look at some forecast temperatures around the nation. Forecast looks like this. Scattered thunderstorms, a low 76, high 89. The boating forecast looks good. Winds east at 10, seas 3 feet or less, and the bays will have a light chop. Bob, that's all we have except for Floyd.
Have a good Sunday.
Okay.